I got lucky that my parents.
Welcome to the Halo Museum.
Wow.
I went out to Gen Con for Ground Battles to launch that with all the fans and stuff, too.
So what do you think, man?
I absolutely love it, dude. This is fantastic. Yeah. Oh, my God. That's the brute from...
We Are ODST.
Yeah. I think you mean The Life. That's the official name.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to take my time.
Oh, there it is. Who had suggested the Halo scarf? Who suggested a Halo scarf? Because here it is.
Oh, yeah, there is one.
Yeah. Well, it's a 343 scarf.
Is that the one that Russian company made?
I don't know, but I don't know what it's a staff one, but yeah.
See, like, I know they made, like, that scarf line with that Russian company, but it was just so expensive.
That'd be great. I will be your unpaid intern. That kind of stuff.
Yeah. See, I'd love something like this, but with a breakdown of what everything is,
yeah.
An in-depth breakdown. But even if it was just a cosplay guide, I'd freaking love that sort of thing.
I saw the Halo original Xbox guy. At a...
I like how he's all alone.
He's a little depressing.
Years ago, I ordered a full set, like they had the whole set of whatever the 10-year anniversary was. It got lost in shipping.
Oh.
I could never find another one, unfortunately. That's from Deliver Hope.
This isn't the one that guy made, right? That's huge.
No. That's from Deliver Hope. It was made by Legacy or whatever. Oh God, HeroClix, I still have this. There is a Halo flask. I need a Halo flask.
Cassie, isn't that, like, crazy? Like, it feels
I'm
weird. That's real.
There's Kat. It's from,
trying to figure out materials.
And his little jaw. Yeah, I see.
Are they posable?
Nice.
No,
actually, they're on the front. Like, they have, like, a switch that can move and kind of flap, but,
It's a cat. It's so squishy.
Oh, wow, that is crazy. Yeah, it's just normal foam.
Why did anybody suggest a Noble helmet when we were talking about, like,
that? Oh, God, yeah, why didn't we? It's so funny how this used to be, this design used to, well, not it used to be so hated when Halo Reach came out.
Yeah.
But now it's so iconic. Unless it's the Decimator version from Halo 5, apparently. Which I can understand. I'm not a big fan of it. I have this at home. I got
from GameStop, right?
Yeah. This one's in slightly better condition than mine, but...
That's mine, actually.
Nice. It's in slightly better... Yeah. Mine, the arm had fallen off when the person who had it before me. So he did like a... He did a full restoration, then sold it to me for $270. He picked it up at like $200.
Miss Campbell's doing some touch-up stuff for this on me for me, too. So.
Oh. It's going to look even more fantastic. Oh, God.
Oh, it's not like the...
Halo Slurpees.
President Peters, I presume. CMA.
Hey, Paul. You should donate your ODST helmet to their case. They don't have one.
I have my lucky my car.
Oh, no. This is a...
Brood from We Are ODST. It's funny, you go from like the soft foamy fingers to the hard claws.
I have one of those.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, I love the five one with the sounds. I get so excited.
Oh, I know. I actually loved the 4 one. The 4 one had some great sounds to it.
Yeah. They had one of these on sale at a local game shop for years. I could never pick it up. Now I can't get
woods. Like,
yeah, this is.
Did you see? We got a.
This is beautiful.
Yeah, Mythos open.
Yeah, we were. Oh, no.
Yeah, we were. I was looking through it. All the scenes that were in there. Holy crap!
You
found that, yeah. When they were in Onyx.
Yep.
Fred and them, and I'm like, I slid it over, and he was just like, drooling.
Yeah. Kilo fives in there?
Yeah.
Yeah, they, I saw that.
We took a peek at.
By the end, I was like, I just kind of looked at everything. Yeah, yeah. More beginning. I love the proto banshees. Those things are beautifully designed.
They sick.
Yes. Oh,
trust me.
Was like, that? Oh, banshees.
Yeah.
So I'll recommend something to go look at.
Good old game feel.
Yeah.
I'm wearing my old record.
We have the. I actually really like the FUD version that we submitted for award.
Oh yeah, the one episode. Yeah, I got one of those.
I'm so glad I missed out on this one too. Even if I don't care for the armor choice.
I ate bullets for breakfast.
Hey, there's Beamish's thing. And this cryo suit. Oh wow, mini stick. Mini version of the. There you go, Sweet William cigars. Ask his dismissal.
Well, I know you did like the. What's it called? I know they.
Well, it's not my favorite armor. It's definitely. That is surprisingly foamish. Oh, wow, that's all foam.
Oh, it looked like Western.
Touch the crotch.
Did you see his, like, his undersuit is just falling to pieces.
That is sad.
It was kept, like, not totally dry.
Yeah.
And they had, like, some baby oil or something they were using.
Yeah.
Like, when he was wearing the costume or something. And somehow it's, like, totally degenerated all of those little pieces. So
that's too bad.
Yeah. So we have to figure out. We're probably going to repair the new.
It's not my favorite armor design, but it's still a nice costume. I personally would have preferred the Halo Wars for this.
Oh yeah.
I'm big on continuity like that, but.
Well, they did add this.
Yeah, but I mean, like,
change a few things.
I could go on a rant on what doesn't make sense canon wise, but I won't bore you.
I absolutely know, because that's my department, and
yeah,
that's all I hear about.
Oh, I'm Ian. I run the Halo Canon site, YouTube. Oh, okay. I don't know if you've ever...
No, I mean, I know your site, but yeah. I don't think we've ever met.
I know we haven't. Yeah, definitely haven't.
I'm the Halo
met.
Franchise manager, so...
Absolute pleasure to meet you.
I work with all the writers and the people that try to keep the continuity, so...
Yeah.
Things after retcon, we're like,
I mean, for the most part, you guys do a fantastic job. Like, I still think one of my favorite things you guys... I don't know if you were personally on board for this, because this was back with CEA, when they tried to... do a lot more of the merging between Fall of Reach and Halo Reach with the data drops specifically. So, still one of my favorite things. And then now with Ground Command and Fleet Battles. Yeah. So.
That's all Ken. He actually writes the
rules
and does all the trying to tie everything together. So,
yeah. Well, for the best you guys are left with, you've done a really good job with it, in my opinion.
Yeah. And it's funny because even for all my bitching, all the things that Bungie was retconning already, like when they still had it.
Yeah.
So we're like. Now, how do we make it all kind of work? So.
Yeah. What you're left with. Oh, that is so much bigger.
We actually underestimated the size, and we had to cut a hole in the ceiling to make it fit.
Oh.
Like, I don't know if you can really see it.
I can kind of see it a little bit.
Yeah. So we thought it was going to be a little bit more at an angle.
Yeah.
Like, when we measured it and stuff, we're like, oh, but it's at an angle, so it'll fit. And then we cut it, and we're like, oh, crap.
Oh God, that's heavy.
Hey.
Have you picked this thing up? This thing is. The pistol's not too bad, but the SMG is crazy heavy.
Yeah, it's really weird. It's uneven. Some weapons have that.
Well, that's a night kind
of. Some of them do. You know what I mean?
That thing surprised me with the weight. Yeah, that's. I'd buy that if they ever decided to do that, release something like that.
That's interesting because I was in the Air Force. And we had to carry rubber guns during battle week, and they were it's pretty similar to that.
Yeah.
I mean, same kind of weight. And
are these actual areas that we're using?
Yeah, but I did. I was never military or anything, but I did sword, and one of the training swords I eventually ended up getting was an optional thing, but you can fill it with sand or just the weight so you get used to a real sword's weight. I ended up filling mine up so it would actually weigh more, so it made regular swords a lot lighter, or feel a lot lighter at least. So that's one way to... go about it.
I got hit in the Fox guarding hand like 6 times, thank you.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
I was surprised at how much this guy weighed.
Yeah, somebody can kind of tell if it's a hero prop or not by the mass of it.
Yeah.
I will say, impressive velocity. That's one from Nightfall. The battery somehow just broke, so the night lights don't come on. But then we have other hero versions, which actually have the rack slide and all that kind of stuff.
Oh, that's awesome.
That
one
you
didn't know what it was?
Mantis in the back. Also surprisingly heavy.
Well, this is actually the actual prop.
Oh yeah. Even still.
The lights come on and everything too. Yeah, they took the battery out. The lights do come on in this thing.
I believe it.
Yeah, well, believe me. It has a yellow light.
I believe, I'll take your word for it. wow, there's your full-size BO. Is that a full-size BO? Or is that even that
size? That would be full-size. It should be the same size as this one.
Okay, so yeah, so full-size BO.
Well, yeah,
Kevin was better. Yeah, I could tell. Like, talking about that last night, I could tell when they were in the film, like it comes across how awkward so those things
what
are.
What I always think is funny is like the SMG is like perfectly reasonable size, but when you see Max use it, looks like he's wielding a pistol.
Yeah.
7 feet tall.
Yeah.
But when you
I can care less about all the high end stuff. And it's like, oh, right? I can pull it out, and if one of the other guys doesn't have it, they'll be ready.
Guys, there's a nuke! Watch out! What was the colonial?
Even one
Nightfall colonial.
It's from a canceled retailer, which was kind of like Target. It was called Zellers. It fell through years ago.
Oh wow, there's an armor ability. Oh no, that's the. It's the light. It's the hollow wall. Probably based off the armor ability, I guess. If you want to connect the fiction, I don't know why I never thought about that. Probably.
Well, exactly. Hold on, should I shoot you with the extended bag?
So with
please.
Do you want me to shoot you?
Sure. Go for it. Here.
Again?
I was never shot.
No,
so.
Don't break his legs. I can't. If you're gonna film it.
Oh,
I'll shoot you over there.
Can we film it for you?
Yeah, sure, if you want.
I mean,
I'm gonna
point it at you.
Yeah. Let's get through the rest of this stuff.
Can you do your thing?
And then we'll film me getting shot.
Hey Dust. Cable Canon, we will film some shot.
Did you see the tower?
Oh wow. That's crazy. Helmet.
Don't breathe too hard around this.
No.
There's a bunch of guys for the show that ended up taking some home.
That was the day that I actually
came out. Mega gave me
Wow.
Yeah.
It's one thing to see that in video form, but to see it up close. How did they keep the perks together? I can never keep them together.
Oh, yeah, it was a fun question.
It was a great reveal.
Yeah,
that's a reveal.
Awesome.
Just slip out.
They were like, I wanted this.
Oh, wow. This thing is huge. Oh, man. Forgot about that. Okay, so this was from Halo Fest.
We are a tall bunch, aren't we?
No longer cool. Yeah. It's something.
It's like going into the film or something.
She's exposed.
Going into her dark room.
Yes.
This is exactly your jam, man.
We were going to have some concept art boards.
Our collection of helmets.
But a few trinkets. Yes, just a few. Uprising. Completely underrated.
Oh my gosh, it's I am the words.
Sorry.
I wanted
how awesome though was
wow.
I mean, it's like even Matt was so good at capturing that.
Doing it,
but he's working on some new stuff.
But how hard is it to take one of those ships, put a whole fish eye screw on it, and say, hey, here's
the coda.
But yeah,
you know,
yeah. One thing I just wanted to see though is I wanted more team, I guess.
For like Alpha 9?
Yeah. Like, I want to see the boys talk to each
the
other.
The nice thing is that there's always room for more stories with them.
Yeah.
So.
and better too short than too long.
That's true.
I like it.
I'd much rather give it to me.
I didn't buy one, but I didn't get one. It worked out for me, but
yeah, I wish we did more of like the engraved. Like we have one of the white. So some of those were actually just done custom. We just went out to a local laser engraver. We had an EPS file, and then. God damn it, why am I suddenly
which photos?
Angel. Yes, Angel went out.
Okay. Okay. So, I really like that.
Yeah. Oh, nice, Spartan Assault. Assault was pretty good. Strike, I think, was a nice improvement.
I bumped into you there.
I never finished Assault. I'm planning to get Strike, but I don't know.
I eventually need to go through and like reshoot all my footage for it, for all my stock footage, essentially.
Yeah.
Especially, I had never got any stock footage of the co-op.
Oh yeah,
which that was fantastic. Did you ever get to play through all that?
No.
If you ever want to, hit me up. I'd happily play that because I love the co-op for that.
Hold on. Now.
One.
Yeah, let's go. Oh! That actually doesn't hurt at all. It's just a little bit.
I live with two other guys that are big gamers, and we bought a magnet for when someone.
That was for me. Three.
No, because all of our
Carter's armor. Oh. Arms falling off. That's some cool. Yeah. But even still, like even with jeans on, I would have expected that to hurt a lot more.
I'm sure after the initial shock.
Yeah, it was that's all I got that it was. Like, and then it's like, wait a minute, this doesn't hurt at all. I dare say it's almost pleasant. Almost.
Whatever you go.
Okay. Ooh. Want to hold the camera for me for a second?
Yeah,
it's already recording, so.
Okay. What am I recording of?
Just me holding the weapons.
Okay.
Jesus, that is. Have you held these yet?
No. Well, yeah, actually, I have.
Yeah. It's, oh, God, the DMR just looks. Oh, one thing, that's heavy as hell. It looked heavy in the film, but you can feel that now. Oh, God, I just can't imagine aiming at this thing. Even though I am right now. It's that hard to imagine, folks. AR's pretty handsome. Oh, wow. Rubber trigger. I don't want to do that too much. Stick them up.
No.
Fine. Maybe this will convince you. That thing, holy shit.
See, I don't understand why in Halo their weapons are so giant.
It's only because this is supposed to be scaled for Spartans. They should scale them down for the average Marine.
Well, yeah, exactly. It's like, who the hell?
They could be life size.
Like a sniper rifle.
Well, I mean, even then, though, like the original lore was like, you know, the Magnums.
I mean, how is someone supposed to be like?
Yeah. Well, I mean, to be fair, that's usually a smart link for the skull, but I hear you. But I mean, the original lore was like, even as far back as Halo CE, it was like, yeah, this has all been upscaled for Spartans, so.
Can you take a picture?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
I mean, the whole put it still, but my gosh, you can't do it. You can't do it.
Well, that's what the smart link's for. They made the, you know, in the future they make the ammo or the weapons gigantic. Then it's like, oh crap, our people can't aim them. Then they invent the smart link.
So they did this for Nightfall?
Yeah, that one specifically I know is for Nightfall. I don't know about any of the others.
Because when they have to go up to go on the shoot, I mean, they're just...
Yeah. Well, I mean, if you really look, for me at least, when I was watching Nightfall, I could tell how awkward those weapons were for all of them.
You should have put the scope... Yeah, this is almost like on gear of a new sniper.
But yeah, but I mean, like, this is also something, canonically, it's supposed to be scaled up for a Spartan. The, you know, a marine-sized DMR would theoretically... Oh, I didn't even notice that. Cool.
But, my gosh, my left arm is getting so tired right now.
Theoretically, a proper marine-sized DMR would be a lot smaller.
Seriously,
but,
if this other round's going into a thing like this...
Well, see, that's why they had to upscale the guns.
Yeah, no, this is just nuts. I would have to hold it like this.
Go Rambo style it.
Yeah. I mean, I like the look of the deal.
Yeah.
The AR makes more sense.
Oh, hey, silenced. I don't think I got to hold this one before. First person shooter it.
See? You know, it's much better...
Yeah, that's like better sized.
Exactly. But again, this is what an SMG is for, compact.
Yeah.
Going in.
Or the pistol, pretty nice. Shoot your nuts off.
Like, it makes sense for normal size of like MP5s and that sort of thing.
Yeah. So the UNSC upscales everything, but then they got to the SMG and it's like, nah, it's fine. Spartans can still use it. That one's pretty. I'd say that one's pretty decent. I don't know, actually. I'm no firearms expert, so I don't know.
You're American. You should know.
Hey, I don't appreciate your stereotyping.
What do you mean? All Americans have guns. 500 million of them to only 300 million Americans, so I assume that almost everyone has one.
I mean, you know.
Good luck for Canada trying to buy one. Good lord, you have to jump through so many hoops.
Yeah. Still not entirely clear with how good, if that's good or not, though. Like, if you were to try to implement that system now in America, it would never work, but if we'd had something like that from the beginning.
Lord, no, that would just.
Well, I mean, not even taking into consideration people's feelings about it, or just our legal issues.
The amount of illegal guns being purchased would just skyrocket.
Yeah, but I mean, like now, but like it makes you wonder if you had that from day one, like from the founding of the country, how that would have worked out.
Oh my gosh, this is cool.
You know, when it was created, it was like.
Why is this wool? For the love of God, these are actors. You don't want to torture them.
Apparently they did.
Yeah, because stuff like this, I would like to have, like, to actually have stuff like that.
Yeah.
You know?
That is beautiful. I'm amazed they're letting us touch everything, too. Like, part of me doesn't want to, because, like, the collector in me says, no, you shouldn't touch these. But then it's like, you have the fan in me is like, dude, you gotta touch them. Oh my god.
It's a hot damn.
I don't know that I could
really cool.
I don't know that I could pick a particular favorite. There's just
or some highlights.
The big ass oversized weapon, which makes me think now: is this actually undersized or is this correctly scaled? I'm curious. Lunch at 343. It's awesome. Halo stuff. I've had the albums for years, and I've still never listened to them. I still got to get a turntable to listen to the disc versions. Fall of Reach. First Strike. In a room of nerdiness, the likes of which has probably been seen before.
Oh, look at these selfies.
What is this hammer from? Oh, I didn't. That was from.
This is the Nightfall.
Yeah, I was like trying to figure out what the hell the hammer is, but then it's like, oh, that's when they're mining the magic elements that can apparently kill people with somehow, and only humans. Don't I?
The backdrop on one of the commander's propellers.
Oh yeah, the Carmilla wall.
Oh nice. That's a good
studio.
But this is where the live streams happen. So this is the setup. So next time you're watching a live stream, in fact, our next one is on Tuesday the 6th. Next time when you're watching it, you kind of like actually have a visual idea of where things are and what's happening. So obviously host chairs are here. So when we're playing on these screens. And if we're playing 4v4, it's these screens and the other four people are sitting right here. Okay. So when you hear them yelling and stuff, that's where they're at. We're also linked in with our playtest lab. So when we're doing bigger stuff, so if we're doing like a Warzone or a Warzone Assault or stuff like that, we're actually linked in with the play lab as well. So what?
Can we simulate a live cast?
You can ask Chad.
Oh my god.
It's a simulated basement.
That's what we like to tell the public.
Cassie has a question?
But yeah, if anybody has any questions, yes?
The Spartan. Is that actually from the set?
That is from the set. Yeah, that is the Spartan from Corbulo Academy from Halo Forward Under Dawn.
And it's glowing.
And it is glowing. It is post slashed through with an elite energy sword.
Spoilers.
Yeah. Should have seen it.
Wait, how did an elite get to the Corbulo Academy?
What?
That's like... Oh,
find out, Jeff.
Find out next time on Dragon Ball Z.
A bigger question is, how did Hamish Beamish get to Corbulo Academy? And that question is answered in the form of a poem written by Frank in Halo Fractures.
Yep.
Yeah. No one else knows that. Like, that's not even being advertised, so you guys are hearing that first. The Ballad of Hamish Beamish will be in Halo Fractures. You are all under Friendly A. So, cue to play Halo 5. They would come over and do the HoloLens experience. HoloLens is, if you've not gotten to try it, it's always one of those things that, like, you imagine you're saying it, but you're in the back of your mind, you're secretly like, I don't think this is actually going to work, it's just marketing. But this is actually one of those things where I like tried it and I'm like, holy crap, that actually worked. Like, yeah, it's really, really cool. So wait, basically, you would have your HoloLens glasses on, you'd stand around here, and while you were waiting to play Halo 5, Sarah Palmer would come up and give you a mission briefing, and you could actually like look all around it, and it was literally legit, like she was popping up and you were on a ship. Nobody else could see it. Like, you just looked crazy to anyone without the glasses. Yes. But you can see it, and they would bring like Phaetons up or enemy units and spin them around. You want a five? Or?
No, I was just gonna say, does this thing still function?
With glasses.
Yeah, but if we brought our HoloLens.
The stuff's in the HoloLens.
I know, but that's what I'm saying. Right?
Yes. Yeah, I'm just gonna say yes.
Okay. You guys heard it.
And then behind you, right over there, is the June statue from the Reach. Legendary statue, yeah.
So this is where he went after Reach?
You put in line to play Halo 5.
Yep.
Sorry. Good times.
Yes.
Yeah.
Five memories. That's the only one I've ever seen, right? Yeah, I've never seen him screwing around
with those things. He didn't talk to me. Damn. What is this? X-ray.
Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you liked this video, please consider giving it a thumbs up, subscribing, and sharing it around. You are the reason I get to keep doing this, so thank you. Profusely thank you. If you want to dive deeper into Halo's lore, head over to the Halo Archive. It's a lore-based community that welcomes everyone from experts to rookies. No matter what your working knowledge, you'll be sure to find a friend and a good time.